Our next presenter is Cristina Hajosy, and her presentation is Pasted Inside and Out, Contemporary Paste Papers and Book Arts.
Hi, everybody. I'm excited to be back. Last year, I participated in Ignite with paper marbling. But paste is the subject today. So I'm a book artist, and I work a lot with taking the book arts to another level by making, basically, your own paper designs. I do make some paper as well, but I really get a kick out of going backwards in time to some of the historical ideas. So paste is a medieval Northern European decorative paper technique. I envision a man or a woman having porridge for breakfast, some kind of gruel, and something fell into it, and they discovered that it turned a colorful consistency that they could smear on things. It was probably used to be like a stucco treatment for walls and ceilings originally. But paste is something that's got a little bit of a history in the decorative arts as well. And here you're seeing some of my students over the years creating different textures with the tools. There's a lot of ways to make your own tools. And you can basically create a cooked paste that gets smeared with acrylic across surfaces. And then you start dragging things through it. I use it predominantly in the book art, so here you're seeing a very unusual large-scale flag structure. It's called a flag book. It has a really interesting movable movement in it. And then the visuals here, these are little pieces from a bunch of my students in one big large group project. This is a textile that I'm using on top of the paste to create almost like a fabric kind of quality to it. Depending on the context though, it can actually look like a botanical sometimes. So here you're seeing a Japanese puncture book with that same textile, and now it feels almost like a botanical instead of a textile. It can also go feminist and look like cell structures, like smears of things too. So I'm a feminist artist, so I have a tendency to want to use the paste to create more aggressive kind of, you're using your body and getting in there and getting messy. And so rolling, in this case, pine cones or scraping at the surface to create sort of a little bit more of an angry kind of looking imagery. This is a structure called a star book. It's another interesting a sculptural piece that opens up. You can put text on it, but I think it's just really a fun visual book. You can hang it. I think paste was mainly used as an alternative to leather and cloth for bookbinding originally because it was a lot less expensive. So turning paste on its head and using it on the inside of a book as content actually instead of just purely as decorative material for the outside. This is one of the patterns I do a lot. It's kind of like a cage. It kind of reminds me a little bit of the lobster traps. I grew up in Georgia, and my dad farmed catfish and beef cattle, and we had a lot of weird cage materials laying around that kind of sort of look a little bit like a lobster trap. This piece is called Neighborhood Watch. It's actually 20 feet long. It's currently in a show at the Galatea Fine Art in Harrison with the Women's Caucus for the Arts Group Show. It's got these windows cut out with eyeballs, image transfers of eyeballs looking out the windows. So it's kind of a little bit surreal. I also like to do a lot of body image related materials. So this is an altered book piece that has a lot of childhood sex ed kind of textbooks and stuff on body, how bodies work from the 60s and the 70s. The color palette's really interesting. And I like to do the paste right across pages and then cut out and add other layers, sort of like a lot of collaging and highlighting with found poetry different words that exist on the page. Yeah. So you can see some of the little bit of a more angry kind of image making going on here and selectively showing where I'm obstructing some of the text but not all the text. So it's a very tactile, textural kind of technique. And I really do think that you can get conceptualizations. For me, it's about being trapped in identity and body image and actually in your own corporal reality as well. So I have windows and screens and nettings that you kind of can push your way out of. Here you're seeing some handmade tools as well. This is, my husband's really great at finding weird yard sale stuff for my collage bits and all. So this is a bunch of rolling pins that I've got over the years to create interesting textures as well. Again, very cage-like. I find that a lot of my students that I teach this to end up doing high-res scans and going into the apparel mart with it. So this is actually a piece of silk that has a small repeating pattern. It's very seamless. My repeats are pretty seamless. Same here. They get printed onto all kinds of different textiles. There's a huge print on demand type of online that you can get now. You can print not just on your coffee mugs and your mouse pads, but you can actually do some pretty interesting things like leather purses and iPhone cases, and you can go crazy. So I think that this kind of technique would be a really great skill for you to learn. It will take you out of AC Moore and Michael's Craft Store and get you making paste onto surfaces that you need and the colors you want, the textures you want, and it's really going to change, I think, how you collage and mix media art in the future.